session of electronic devices and circuits. Now we will discuss experiment number 10, which is design and implement of voltage regulator using 3-terminal IC. So before that, we will see the broad diagram of voltage regulator. Voltage regulator means we are expecting the block diagram of power supply, linear regulated power supply. So this is the block diagram of linear regulated power supply. We have input which comes from say margin pro, which is single phase to 30 volt AC, and that is to be given to step down transformer, and its output is given to the rectifier which convert this step down, that is amplitude is now less than 230 volt definitely, this AC volt into pulsating DC. Still we use to remove this ripple or AC content in DC signal, that is, so we use filter, okay, so that will reduce the ripple and it look like this. And finally this unregulated DC voltage is to be given to the regulator, and ultimately we have load across this. And we have constant DC voltage, which is called a regulated voltage. So this is complete block diagram. So our basic work is we have to design 3-terminal IC voltage regulator at certain DC voltages and DC currents. So we will let us see that we will design linear regulated power supply at DC voltage of 12 volt with DC current of say 1 ampere. So to design 12 volt and 1 ampere regulated output voltage, I have to use different types of ratings of transformer, rectifiers, filters and load. So generally the design is to be done from output to input. So before that, means the signal flows through transformer, then rectifier, then filter, then regulator. We must know what are the different voltage drops that takes place in each block. So from this step down transformer, one signal goes through rectifier. Here we have choice, either we use full wave rectifier or bridge rectifier. So as we know, in case of bridge rectifier, the peak in PIV rating, that is peak inverse voltage rating, is less, which is 2 mA, and in case of full wave rectifier, which is twice mA, so PIV of bridge rectifier is less, so that is advantages. One more thing, efficiency as compared to half wave rectifier is good, and very important thing is transformer utilization factor. So this bridge rectifier utilizes transformer effectively, though we use a center tap transformer. So generally bridge rectifier is widely used under this rectifier. So as we say bridge rectifier, in each cycle the two diodes are working, means current signal flows through the two diode, and up till 0.7 volt there is no voltage or there is no signal that flows, so we call it as cutting voltage, so which is 0.7 volt. So 0.7 volt is the cutting voltage in half cycle. So in each half cycle there are two diodes that flows, so we can say that here 0.7 plus 0.7 voltage drop takes place. So ultimately we have 1.4 voltage drop takes place. There is no voltage drop takes place through filter because we are using capacitor filter. There are different types of filter like choke filter, pi filter, okay. And capacitor filter we use because it is readily available in market and capacitor is easy to construct. Then we have regulator. So we are using regulator IC. So basically regulator IC has two types, whether it is component based regulator like Zener diode component or whether it is IC based regulator. In case of IC based regulator also there are two types, like whether it is a fixed type of voltage regulator like 7805, which is plus 5 volt or 7905, which is minus 5 volt, or we can have variable voltage regulator like LM317, which is a variable positive voltage regulator, where we can vary the output DC voltage from particular values in range. Similarly, we can have LM337, which is negative variable voltage regulator. So basically our scope here is to design an adjustable linear voltage regulator, and which is variable, and with the help of 3 terminal IC. So we will use here LM317, which is positive adjustable variable voltage regulator. So, and the voltage drop across this IC is 1 volt. So ultimately, if I want 12 volt output, but to get 12 volt output, I have to go through this 1.4 volt and 1 volt voltage drop. So based on that, I will select the transformer rating, that is the meaning. So how to select transformer rating? This is the first design aspect of our experiment. So if we add this 12 plus 1.4 plus 1, we have 14.4. So definitely I have to choose the transformer which should be more than 14.4. So either we can choose 15 volt or more than 15 volt, like 18 volt. Generally transformer ratings are in triplicate, like 9 volt, 12 volt, 15 volt, 18 volt. So, but here I will use center tap transformer, which is 909. So I will use secondary winding of transformer like this. For example, this is my input winding and this is secondary winding. So I will take this as a ground, and this secondary is completely 9 minus of minus 9. So this is 18 volt. So I will use this type of rating of center tap transformer, which is step down transformer. So the input is 230 volt and my output is 18 volt. So we call it as VSRMS. VSRMS is 18 volt. Now next is we have used a bridge rectifier. But bridge rectifier consists of diode. So which type of diode you use? Which is a semiconductor diode, PPN junction diode, we can say that. Because it is also in the range of 1N4001, 1N4002, up to 1N4007, depending on the peak inverse voltage. For example, 1N4001 has a peak inverse voltage of 25 volts. So it can, at most 25 volt peak inverse voltage it can withstand, otherwise it will get damaged. So first of all, we have to find out what is peak inverse voltage of bridge rectifier. As we stated, bridge rectifier we are choosing. So bridge rectifier's peak inverse voltage is given by Vm. And in case of full wave rectifier, we have twice Vm. So in case of bridge rectifier, the peak inverse voltage is given by Vm. So Vm is given by root 2 times VSRMS. We already know that VSRMS is Vm by root 2. So Vm is root 2 times VSRMS. Already we know what is VSRMS is 18 volt. So we will find out it's root 2 into 18. So it will be nearby like 25 volt or 24 volt, like that. So one thing is very clear, that you cannot use 1N4001. So beyond 1N4001, like 1N4002 or up to 1N4007 we can use. So 1N4007 generally we use because its peak inverse voltage is at most, which is 1000 volt. So beyond that, it cannot generate any voltage, or there is no any such voltage. So, and it is also readily available in market. So generally, the PN junction diode or rectifier diode that we are using here is 1N4007. Next thing is the filter. Now already we have stated that we are using capacitor filter because readily availability of electromagnetic capacitors, we call it as polarized capacitors in market. So we used it, and it is also cost effective. So, but how to choose the particular value of capacitor? So, it is given by the formula. Capacitor filter is given by the formula 1 upon 4 root 3 F into ripple factor into RL. So, from this formula, we came to know what are the different means. This is called ripple factor. Ripple factor of bridge rectifier. So, ripple factor of bridge rectifier is 48%. So, it is less. As compared to half wave rectifier, ripple factor is 121%. So ripple factor is less. What is the RL? RL is very load resistance. So across this load, we are going to find out. So already we stated that VLDC, we want to design 12 volt, RLDC 1 ampere. So RL is just the ratio of VLDC divided by RLDC. So we can say RL is VLDC divided by RLDC, which is just a 12 volt. So now we came to know the value of RL is 12 ohm. We know the RF, that is ripple factor, it is in percentage 48%. In general, we can write it is 0.48. Okay, frequency we know it is a 50 hertz. In India we use 50 hertz. So we can able to find out C because F is 50 hertz, ripple factor is 0.48 and RL is 12 ohm. So we can able to get C value. And the value of C came like near to 500 microfarad. So meaning is beyond 500 microfarad we have to construct, we have to use capacitance at capacitor filter so that the ripple content will be reduced. One thing is very important, ripple will not be removed but it can be reduced. So beyond 500 microfarad we can take any value of capacitor. But one more thing is that we are using 18 volt step down transformer. Secondary winding is 18 volt, which is AC voltage, which is RMS voltage. So beyond 18 volt this filter capacitor voltage should have, and hence we have used 1000 microfarad capacitor filter and having voltage rating 25 volt. So we can have 1000 microfarad 16 volt also, but it cannot be used because VSRMS is 18 volt, that is the reason. Then next is a regulator IC. So already we stated we are using LM317, that is a regulator IC. So now we will discuss what are the basic aspects of how we can get 12 volt output, because now we'll see the block diagram or circuit diagram of LM317 regulator IC. Which is a 3 terminal IC. This is in, this is adjustable terminal and this is output terminal. Output terminal, adjustable terminal, there is one resistor which is generally called as R1 and which is 20 ohm. This is one more resistor generally called as R2 which is 5 kilo ohm. There is one more capacitor at input side which is electrolytic, basically the value is 0.1 microfarad, we call it as C1, and there is one more capacitor at output side which is 1 microfarad, the value is C2. So this diagram is taken from a data sheet of LM317, which is adjustable positive voltage regulator. So this is your unregulated input. That means this part means output of filter capacitor is basically having certain part of ripple, which is basically unregulated. So this unregulated input voltage is to be given through this IC, which is LM317. And the output is regulated. So now we'll see the importance of this capacitors. This capacitor is used when your filter is away from regulator. So that if filter is away from the regulator, there is a chances of addition of distortion or noise. So to reduce the distortion or noise, we are using C1, which is of 0.1 microfarad. And there is one more capacitor at output, which is C2, which is 1 microfarad. When there is the fluctuation takes place at input side, and if there is a transient that occurs, so that should not change my output voltage, but because this, that is a constant voltage. So to reduce the transient, we are using this particular capacitor C2. Now these are the R1 and R2. Here R2 is variable, and which is from 0 to 5 kilo, so that we can vary the output voltage, and is given by the formula Vout is equal to 1.25 into 1 plus R2 upon R1 plus adjustable current into R2. So from data sheet, the adjustable current is given as 100 microampere for LM317 IC. So R2 which is to be valued from 0 to 5 kilo ohm and R1 value which is to 20 ohm. In data sheet, we can feel the R1 value is 240 ohm. So it depends as per the availability of particular resistance in our laboratory. So generally it is 240 ohm, but we have chosen here 220 ohm. So this is the formula, and if I want to obtain output voltage as 12 volt, so if I want 12 volt output voltage and I know R1 which is 220 ohm, I know adjustable current is 100 microampere. The unknown is R2, so I can adjust the value of R2 at that value so that I will get 12 volt. That is the thing. So if you solve this, which is 100 into 10 raised to minus 6 into R2, if you solve this, then you will get the value of R2 is 1.859 kilo ohm. So we are going to verify this value, means we will construct this circuit on breadboard and we'll vary the value of R2 as a, and so that you get 12 volt as on multimeter. And on digital multimeter, if we get 12 volt, at that time we'll take out the value of resistance R2 and we'll check on multimeter. That value of multimeter should be very, very much closer to the value that we get in theoretical, which is 1.859 kilo. That is the verification of value of resistance R2. Similarly, we can vary this resistance R2 minimum and maximum and we'll get output voltage, say for example minimum and maximum. So we can vary this R2 for minimum and we'll find out the value for this particular LM317 IC. Similarly, we'll vary this output voltage and for maximum we'll get a maximum IC. So if we have R2 value minimum, then we'll get maximum output voltage and which is given as 25 volt, and when your R2 value is maximum, then you get output voltage minimum, which is given as 1.25 volt. So this is 1.25 volt, and this is output voltage 25 volt. So definitely LM317 output voltage is in range of 1.25 volt to 25 volt. So similarly, we construct this circuit on breadboard, and we'll literally vary the values of resistance R2. To minimum and maximum, and we will cross check the value of output voltage on digital multimeter, and that is our experiment. Thank you.
Okay, the next experiment is design and implement voltage regulator using adjustable terminal IC, which is 3 terminal. So in theory already we have designed for 12 volt, VLDC 12 volt. So this is the overall circuit diagram of output voltage having 12 volt. So we have started with 0 to 230 volt 50 hertz single phase AC. Then we have used step down transformer which is of 909 volt. So this is what 909 volt. This is center tap transformer. So how to identify primary and secondary? So in this center tap transformer, whenever you will find there are 3 terminals or 3 wire. So definitely this is your secondary, because this is your secondary, because this is center tap. This is positive output voltage and this is negative output voltage, and if you make this ground, then this will be your output secondary voltage. So in this case we are making this as a ground, okay, or we can also float this particular wire, this also possible. This is the primary side, okay, which is 0 to 230 volt as per the circuit. So generally it is mentioned 12 to 2008 means this is the month and this is the year, okay. And this is 909 means 9 plus volt and minus 9 volt, okay, with the help of center tap. So this is center tap transformer which is to be connected to single phase. Next thing is the rectifier, which is bridge rectifier, and we are using diodes. So this is PN junction diode. So if you see this PN junction diode, this is a symbol, anode and cathode. Anode is always positive, cathode is negative. So how to identify the terminal? By observation. So whenever you will find the white ring at one particular end, for example in this case the white ring appears here, so this terminal is called as cathode and the opposite terminal is anode. This is the way to identify anode and cathode. So now as per the circuit diagram, we will construct 4 diodes in bridge fashion, we call it as bridge rectifier. So as per the circuit we will construct it. So this is anode side and this is cathode side, we will construct. Then we have one more anode cathode. This is anode side and this is cathode side. Then this is anode and this is cathode. Make sure that the terminal should go in up to the conduction, because the width of PN junction diode are always thick. So this is anode and this is cathode. So this is the fashion of bridge. So all these 4 diodes, which is rectifier diode, constructed in a bridge fashion, and hence it is called as bridge rectifier. So as per circuit we have mentioned the bridge rectifier. Now I will use 1000 microfarad electrolytic capacitor. This is electrolytic capacitor, and the biggest terminal is positive and this is negative terminal, which is also written mentioned here, negative terminal. So see here, somewhere here I will use this terminal. Consider this is ground, this line is ground and this is positive. So I will use one connecting wire which is in between output of this rectifier towards this. Okay, another terminal of this is connected to ground. So definitely this terminal is nothing but this terminal. So this terminal is this terminal which is connected to ground. Okay, that I have connected. Now next thing is 0.1 microfarad. So I will take one more connecting wire from this, we'll apply somewhere here, and I will take, this is 0.1 microfarad. This is again electrolytic capacitor. The biggest one is the positive and this is negative. So this is positive and this is negative that I have connected here, and then its output is given to input. Now this is LM317 pin configuration. This is LM317 IC. Okay, this terminal, as per this, is adjustable terminal. Middle one is output terminal and this terminal is input terminal. So we have to socket, we have to plug this terminal of IC like this. Okay, now this 0.1 microfarad signal is to be given to input side, means the third terminal. So output of this, output of this is to be given to the third terminal, that is this side. Okay, then next is R1 from the circuit. R1 is 220 ohm, which is to be connected in between output and adjacent, means output and adjacent, means this two. So this is 220 ohm, okay, which is red, red, brown, which is to be connected between first two connecting terminal. So this is 220 ohm. Then one more 5 kilo ohm, this is R-pot. So we have R-pot. This is called as R-pot. R-pot means this resistance will vary. If you find out resistance across this with the help of multimeter, by varying this pot, resistance will vary. This is not 5 kilo ohm. This is rather 10 kilo ohm, and it is also applicable. This is written 10 kilo ohm. 10 kilo ohm R-pot. Okay. How to identify the terminal? The middle terminal is always common, and its adjacent terminal is to be clubbed together so that this will become ground and this will another side. So this is generally given to ground. So in this 5 kilo ohm, this is ground. So this is ground means this terminal should be connected to here as a ground terminal. Somewhere like this. Okay, and this terminal is connected to the adjustable terminal, that is the first terminal. So adjustable terminal is here. This is the first terminal. So here we can vary the R-pot. Okay, the next thing, so up till we have done C, this is 1000 microfarad, 0.1 microfarad, R1, R2, and next is 1 microfarad. 1 microfarad capacitor is to be connected in between output and ground. So this is 1 microfarad capacitor. This is 1 microfarad capacitor. And is to be connected in between output. So output is basically the second number pin. So output directly I have connected output and ground. Ground is this one. So I have connected as it is. And from this output, I want to make output voltage. And with the help of digital multimeter, I will find out certain output voltage. So what I will do, I will make one connector. This is to be connected for ground and this is to be connected for output side. So pin number 2 is output. So with the help of digital multimeter, now digital multimeter, and this will be on DC voltage, and this is to be connected. This is ground and this is connected to positive. This is ground as per the circuit. But one thing is remaining, which is that connection of this 9 volt plus 9 volt minus 9 volt. So this is to be connected here, and another connection is to be done here as per this circuit. As per this circuit. So this connection is here and this connection is here. And now I will give input. Now I want to see the output voltage, which is DC voltage. Basically, this is on DC voltage. I want to see the output voltage. I will vary this R pot and I will see the output voltage. Now I will plug on the input and see this output voltage. Now I will vary the output voltage from minimum. So this is minimum. So this is minimum. So it's 1.243. We know in theory the minimum output voltage must be 1.25 volt and maximum output voltage must be 25 volt. So this is for minimum. I have kept minimum, so it's 1.23, and once I vary this R pot, my output voltage is also vary, which is DC voltage, which is also vary. Now I will keep this as a maximum. So for maximum, I will get 24.39. Rather, I want 25 volt. So practically, I get 24.38. Now my basic design that I have made here was for 12 volt. So I should have 12 volt. So I will make my R2 value such a way that my output voltage must be 12 volt. In theory, I have already designed that what is the value of R2. The value of R2 was 1.859 kilo ohm. Then and then only my output voltage become 12 volt. So now I will verify this 1.859 kilo ohm theoretical value with the practical value. Now I will vary this R2. This is R2. I will vary the R2 such a way that my output voltage must be 12 volt. Okay, so that I have varied. Now I will take out this resistance and now I will plug off this, and with the help of this multimeter I will measure this value of resistance R2. So for R2 I have to use rotary switch up to this cap, this resistance. And I will measure this. This is ground, I know. This terminal is connected to black and this terminal is connected to red. Now I will change. Now see, my output is 1.89 kilo ohm. 1.89 is the practical value of R2. And what is the theoretical value is 1.859 kilo ohm. So this is validate. So the value of R2 is also validate, and we can able to vary the output voltage from 1.25 volt to maximum 25 volt is also validate.